Sairam students, so in this session we will just revise the writing skills which will be there for your exams. Today we'll be doing about story writing, how you need to write a story, what are the things you need to remember when you write a story. So let's revise this particular writing skill. Now, what is a story? As you have learnt, it is written in the format of a narrative. It narrates an incident with its associated happenings. That is, so it's written as a narration. It is written in the form of a narration wherein you are narrating a particular incident that has taken place or something that has happened. It may be real, it may be fictional. So it's in the form of a narration or a narrative. The main purpose of writing a story is to improve creative and imaginative thinking. That is, wherein you write a particular story and you become creative, you use your own imaginative power, your thinking, your creativity, and then develop a particular story in case a situation is given or a particular clue is given, wherein you develop that story according to your imaginations and your thinking. So it basically is trying to test your creativity and your imaginative thinking. Now, these are fictional narratives based on the beginning or outline or hints or clues that are given in the question. Suppose you get a question, you could get something wherein you are just given the beginning, or there is an outline provided for the incident, or there are certain hints or clues. These may be either verbal or it may be a visual clue. So based on this, what is your understanding, what is your imagination about this, you need to make a narrative, a fictional narrative. You need to develop a story based on the clues given to you in the question. So you need to understand your question very clearly. Now let's look into some of the main elements of a story. So here you have, first of all, certain elements, like you have a theme. So theme means it is the main idea. What that question, suppose you're given a question, what is the central theme of that particular incident? What is the message or what is the moral that you gain? Based on that particular main idea or the main theme, you need to develop your story. You need to write your story accordingly. So the understanding of the theme is very, very important when you begin writing a story. Next comes the plot. Now, any story has to be developed in a logical sequence of events. So your events, the entire story has to be sequentially arranged in a logical way so that it becomes interesting. The plot that you develop must be very interesting. It could be an adventurous plot, maybe something very scary, something that is comical, or it may be even something very fictitious, some characters out of the world. So understanding the theme, you need to develop your plot, which becomes very important. You need to understand and develop these sequence of events very properly, very appropriately, in a very logical manner. It has to progress in a very proper manner. Another thing that you need to understand is the setting. That is, what is the background or the location where this particular event is taking place? So you need to give a proper understanding, proper setting, proper background or location of where this particular event or incident is taking place. So this may be either realistic or fictional. So the background what you develop must be very interesting to the readers. Another important element of a story is the characters. The characters that are involved in that particular plot, that particular story. You could take any number of characters. It could circulate around one person. You could give names to that particular person. It may have certain other persons who are supporting certain supporting characters. Also, it may include people, animals, or other living creatures in that particular sequence of events that have taken place. You could just name the person as it is, or you could give a particular name to each character that you are going to present in your story. So the characters must be really very strong. You need to circulate the or revolve around that particular character to develop your story. So characters play a very major role when you write a story. Then comes the mood. Mood means what exactly is the situation, what is the mood of that particular entire event that is being taking place. Maybe a cheerful one, it may be a tensed one, a happy mood. If the situation or if the story plot you're trying to create is very adventurous, so it could be a little scary. There may be some kind of tension involved. Or if it is really comical, it could have a very happy and a jovial, a cheerful mood. So your words, the sentences that you use must be according to the mood that you're trying to create in your particular story. And then comes the climax. Climax is the most interesting part of any particular story, the highest position of a particular incident that can take place, which ultimately may have lot of conflicts involved, lot of difficulties, certain problems, where it is the highest, maybe the peak of a particular story, which needs to be very interesting and thrilling so that the readers are immediately attracted towards your story and would like to read more about that particular incident that may have taken place. And this particular climax or this leads to a conclusion in your story. That is, what are the things you have done to resolve that particular conflict, or what is the end of that particular story or that incident that you have mentioned in your plot. So what happens at the end that gives you your conclusion. So these elements of your story needs to be understood very carefully. So let's see some points that you need to remember when you write a story. Students, take note of these in your book so that it will be easy for you to understand them and apply them in your exams as well. So the start of the story must be very interesting. The way you begin your story has to be really catchy. Focus should be on the incident. Whatever clues you're given or hints given, you need to focus your entire story on that particular incident only. Don't go off track. Just develop that incident according to your creativity and imagination. Frame the story keeping in mind the central character. So when you understand what the story needs to revolve around, you need to develop your story keeping in mind that particular central character. It could be a person or an animal. So whatever be the character, accordingly you need to develop your story. Build the plot well, leading to an interesting climax, and then arrive at a proper conclusion. So you need to build up your plot. Like we learned, the plot, the things that you are planning to do, what kind of a situation it is, the event is, Accordingly, you need to develop and reach a particular climax, that is the highest position of a story, and then come down to resolve that particular conflicts that may have occurred so that you give a proper conclusion to your story. So there is to be a good conclusion in your story. Of course, you need to add twists and turns to develop the reader's interest. So in between, you could use lot of maybe phrases, certain reported speech kind of things wherein there is a conversation happening between the characters. Lot of twists and turns which makes the story really interesting, and the readers find it really good to read. They find it very interesting to read. Always write the story in past tense. So you need to remember that you have to write your story in the past tense only. From your exam point of view, if you write it otherwise, your marks would be deducted. So students, please write the story only in the past tense. Stick to the limit of 150 to 200 words only. Don't make it too lengthy, otherwise you lose track and the story also may turn out to be a little boring. So you need to stick to your word limit of 150 to 200 words only, so that your story is good and interesting for the reader to read. Keep the language very simple. Don't use complicated language and confuse yourself. Keep it very straight and simple, of course grammatically correct, but maintain the simplicity in your language. Make sure to give an appropriate title to your story. This is very important. A title carries marks, so you need to give a very suitable and appropriate title to the story that you are going to write. Add a moral or message, if any, at the end of a story. There may not be a moral or message always in a story. If there are certain stories that revolve around some values that you get out of it, you need to give a message or a moral, what you have learned from this story or what you intend giving to the readers, what message you want to give to the readers. So keep this in mind. Also, write the story in 3 to 4 paragraphs only. Don't exceed this. Your paragraphs need to be maintained. You have to write it only in 3 to 4 paragraphs. So these things or these points need to be remembered before you write a story. So in the format, you will have first the title, which is very important. You have to write it in different paragraphs where you have an interesting start. That is your introductory paragraph where you need to begin the story. Second paragraph and the second and third could be related to the plot, building up the plot, where you have what kind of events you are going to plan out, how the situations, how the events are taking place, the sequence of events, and maybe reaching a climax. That is a most interesting part of a story. So the climax. And your concluding paragraph has to be a proper conclusion, where maybe you have resolved some problems that have occurred or you're giving a proper ending to your story. And finally, you write a message or a moral in case the story has one. So this format needs to be followed. You need to leave a line after every paragraph. Begin your paragraph from the margin, from the left hand side of your page, so that your letter or your story is very appropriate. So this format needs to be followed when you write a story. Now you can see this diagram here, where you have a progression, how the plot has to be developed. you can see this is the structure of how you need to write a story. So first you have exposition, where you have the character, the setting you need to take into account. Then you have where you're moving forward towards the climax. You have rising action, that is you're moving towards certain events that have taken place or some problems. Finally, you have the climax, which is the highest position or maybe a turning point of your story. There may be some kind of suspense, some adventure happening there. Then it comes down where you are having certain actions that are being taken place. And finally, you have a resolution where you give a proper conclusion to your story. So your plot, the story has to develop in this manner. So this needs to be given in 3 to 4 paragraphs. Okay, so now let's see some examples how you could get certain questions like. So here you have write a story in about 150 to 200 words with the following beginning and give a suitable title to it. So now here you're given only the beginning of that particular story. Like Rahul was alone at home. Suddenly the phone rang. So now you have to begin your story with these sentences only and continue with it. Maybe you could say like what happened when he received the phone call, some kind of incident that has taken place. So you need to develop the story according to your imagination and creativity. It could be a scary and adventurous story. So accordingly, a comical story. So understand and make the plot looking at the situation. You may also get stories where you have or outlines given. So you need to develop using these outlines. So now here you have the hints given. You were in the market, came across an old woman begging, took pity on her, gave her money, also thought of taking her to a nearby restaurant. You turned back, could not find her. So here it could make, it could be a story where the lady had vanished all of a sudden. So you could create a plot accordingly. Or maybe the lady was so thankful that she didn't want to wait there. So she was so obliged and she left the place. So according to your creativity, use these hints to develop your story. Now here you could also get a question where you need to write a story in 150 to 200 words using the visual clue. Now just look at this figure, this picture, what you understand in this picture. You need to develop a story looking at this picture. So now here it could be, you can see the bank, you can see a person running away with a bag. So it could relate to some kind of a bank robbery, or you could also take it as a story wherein you could make a plot where this person is following someone. He is maybe a detective, an agent who is trying to catch someone, or in general, he is just a general person who with the current situation is masked. He is trying to protect himself from COVID, so he has a mask on his face and he is moving in the near the bank. So you develop a story according to what you feel this picture is, how you understand it, what is your imagination about this picture. So these are ways in which you could get stories, but the progression of the story remains the same. You need to follow the format very strictly. So understand the format and develop the story accordingly. So for your exams too, learn the format very well so that you're able to write good stories. This is just for the information. You will also have questions on your literature section. So the portion for standard 9 to class 9 is, you have Fun They Had, The Road Not Taken, and The Lost Child. So these chapters you need to learn. Read your lessons very well. You could get questions from your textbook. Also for class 10, you have a letter to God, fire and ice, dust and snow, a triumph of surgery. So these chapters again you need to do well. You need to read your lessons well. You could get questions from anywhere from the lessons. So be thorough with your lessons. Students, a portion for grammar for class 9 and also for class 10 are clauses and tenses. So go through the videos that have been done, also these revision videos well, so that you understand and do the portion well. In the writing skills section, again for both class 9 and class 10, you have formal letter writing and story writing. So in both these, do your format really well, understand the format, and go through the videos again, the revisions that is being given to you, and do the writing skills well. Do the things right. Thank you.